Councillor Rania Khan from Tower Hamlets. So,
good evening, everyone. First of all, really pleased to be here. For me, the People's Assembly speaks to me because it's the way I've been doing politics. And I've always done politics as an assembly of neighbours, as an assembly of citizens, and an assembly of people, really. And I do apologise that my speech may be slightly geared towards attacking Trump, but I'll try to reduce it as much as I can. Sometimes I really wish I had those, you know, reaching goals and we can just, like, you know, do one off the day. Anyway, ordinary people, young, old, black and white, straight and gay, people of all faith and none, this is what, for me, the People's Assembly is, standing up to take part in our democracy, striving for a better deal for the poor, the vulnerable, the 99%, against the stranglehold on power enjoyed by the 1%, against entrenched, wealthy, vested interests, and against austerity. This government, this right-wing government, is really out of touch, as we all know. And it's declared a war on public service, on ethnic minority community, on multiculturalism. These people have an ideological zeal for rolling back the state and attacking the most vulnerable. They think they can con us through their media and their propaganda, and their own propaganda is very powerful. I mean, I have friends in my colleagues at work, I'm a teacher, and I'm shocked at really, like, these people are working class and how they are kind of excluded and they have misconception and they support the Tory government's policies in terms of cutting benefit tax and etc. So our fight has to go far and beyond, not just with our friends, but we really have to reach very deep on. So when they decide to close our schools and our hospitals and our police stations and our children's centres, it is, they say it's necessary because of financial crisis. Well, we will not be conned and we will not be deceived. And my message to David Cameron is we all know that this is not about deficit. This is about redistributing opportunities from the poor and to create a class warfare. But it is about, but it is this rare-filled kind of elitist political class that is waging a war on the working class. We will stand up for public services and everything that Britain is great for, and especially our NHS. There is nothing necessary about the cuts, and we all know that. And that's why in Tower Hamlets, we are not cutting frontline services, and we are trying to invest and make them, in fact, better. We have built more social, affordable homes than any other council in the country. We have reinstated the scrapped education maintenance allowance in a new sense copied by the progressive councils. We have brought in £1,500 bursaries to assist poor students going to university, and I believe it's going to help about 2,000 students in Hamlets. We have about 4,000 students going to university, so half of them will be supported, hopefully. We were the first council to introduce the London living wage. We are the only council in Britain to provide free home care for elderly and vulnerable residents. We have made no cuts to our libraries, youth centres, or children's services. In fact, we're opening up new library and children's centre, a new one out here just around the corner here in Shadville. We have created over 4,000 jobs and hundreds of apprenticeships and training opportunities. And of course, I'm proud of our leadership, the mayor as well, has worked in conjunction with Unite to establish the first Unite community centre at St George's in Shadville. We're working with local people and particularly the unemployed to empower them. And I want to obviously thank Ellie for her central role in making this happen. And this council is putting the people first. This council puts people at the front of the decision. And as far as I'm involved, it will obviously. Thank you for inviting me to speak at this meeting. And at the moment, I'm reading. I get very little time to read, but I'm reading a Shape of Horror's diary. And one thing that I'm learning from read up in the hardware, actually, and it's really interesting, is that, you know, their resilience, and even when they had like 8 soldiers, their resilience to continue and to fight the oppressive regime. And I think we should learn a lot from that. And we should never give up hope, and if they want to instill this fear in us, we should give it to them. And it isn't just about talking to our friends that we usually see on a day-to-day basis, but we have to reach far and beyond, and we have to instill that hope in people, because people think every day I have people in my surgery, every Saturday that I hold my surgery, you know, women come into my surgery, and men, and they are literally crying they're going to lose their homes, their children will have to move schools. And it's quite heartbreaking, and sometimes you think I'm a bit immune to it, but you know, I don't want to. But it, you know, I've had women come into my surgery crying and saying, can you do something on you? But obviously, my hands are limited. So we have to instill a sense of hope in people and not to be feared, because fear is the first thing that this college can do, is put fear in people, you in the school. So yeah, I just want to say that you need to really work hard and really instill hope in people that there is a kind of light in the future. Thanks.